On November 2nd, 2010, the surfing world was forced into a collective state of shock. Philip Andrew Irons, the pride of Kauai and a living legend, gone at the age of 32.
Happiness hit her like a train towards her. Stuck still, no time.
He was able to surf these incredible reef breaks. And also that little competitive zone down at Pine Trees, just trying to compete within that sort of community.
She hid in the wrong corners and she hid under beds. She killed it with kisses.
The first time I watched that movie, Roar Irons, when I was like probably 13 or right at the age where you're just so psyched on surfing. And yeah, just everything about that guy surfing, I loved. He was one of my favorite surfers.
He just drew different lines than most conventional. And he did it with flair and style and power.
I thought he certainly had the talent and the ability to be able to beat anyone in the world.
World Tour became the dream tour. It was absolutely custom made for him, you know, Tavarua, Chopu.
He kicked and scratched his way all the way from here to here, and like was.
Since day one when I met him, we started competing against each other, and it was just like a rivalry instantly.
Reasons I watch those CT contests because of Andy was in it, you know? Otherwise, I probably would have never watched them.
Run fast for your mother, run fast for your father, run for your children, for your sisters and brothers, leave all your
legs. He's always been one of my favorite surfers, and he's pushed me as much as Tom Curran has, you know?
While wearing a competition jersey, Andy took no prisoners. 19 tour victories, 4 triple crowns, 4 pipe masters, 3 world championships. But it is the ferocity of his free surfing, from 2 feet to 25 feet, that will remain burned in our brains.
And I must fight for our rights.
It didn't matter if it was 1 foot or 100 foot, he would try and surf the wave exactly the same, and just he just attacked it.
Let's fight.